The economic recovery has accelerated here and overseas. So, can the Reserve Bank really keep interest rates this low for three more years? Our thoughts on the outlook with one quarter of 2021 behind us. The first 3 months of the year was one-way traffic for strong economic data, measured by jobs growth, business confidence, export volumes, and the property market. Residential property prices rose in March at their fastest pace in over 30 years, which is a challenge for housing affordability and for those trying to get into the market. But the RBA are looking at the positives this brings, including consumer confidence and household spending, and are insistent that this is an issue for lending standards and perhaps other prudential levers to pull, but not for interest rates. The market isn't so sure, now factoring in higher RBA interest rates by the end of next year, which would be consistent with the sharp fall in the unemployment rate, down to 5.8% in February, and further upgrades to GDP growth. The International Monetary Fund is now forecasting 4.5% growth for our economy over this calendar year and 6% growth for the global economy, although this remains highly dependent on vaccine programs here and abroad and ongoing fiscal support. The largest upgrades from the IMF were for the United States and the UK, both who are well ahead on vaccinations compared to European Union countries and most Asia-Pacific nations. So again, the vaccine is the key unknown variable ahead and is the only realistic bridge between the surprisingly strong economic position we're in today and the even stronger conditions that the financial markets are implying we're heading towards. The markets aren't always right when it comes to these types of projections, but it is worth reflecting on the recent positive news beyond vaccines from the US. Biden's $1.9 trillion support package followed with the $2.2 trillion US dollar infrastructure package, driving a sharp rise in US sentiment, including the ISM manufacturing index up to its highest level since 1983. As a result, stock markets are back near record levels in the States, and while our markets have lagged the US, we're still up 8% year-on-year compounding over the last 3 years, and similar returns over the longer term. Given the official cash rate is 0.1%, this is great news for investors and for super funds. But like property markets, the question is how sustainable this will be as interest rates start to rise. For the moment, the optimists are in the driver's seat. So, assuming more good news is coming on the path to the post-pandemic economy, like the Trans-Tasman travel bubble, and as long as fiscal policy is correctly calibrated, best stick with the optimists. Next month's federal budget will give us more news on the fiscal front, which does need to keep doing most of the heavy lifting to avoid an over-reliance on rock-bottom interest rates. By then, we'll also have a read on how the jobs market is coping post-JobKeeper. But the high level of job vacancies should also give us cause for a cautious optimism. And that's the market update from Bendigo Bank.